gotta get out of here.
Coming out of the first half of this season, seeing the prison fall, not really knowing who's where and whether some of these characters even survived or not, that's really exciting.
Don't look back.
It's gonna be about how do we get everybody back together? How do we stay safe? And how do we find sanctuary?
Our characters who thought they had found a safe haven once again realized that perhaps there is no such thing in the zombie apocalypse.
Hey, you!
We've had the sanctity and the security of the prison for a season and a half, and we're on the road again.
People have been spun into orbit. Everybody's been separated.
And it's a terrifying world that we inhabit again.
There are a lot of people who are on foot.
They are seeking to reunite. Some of them decided to leave others behind.
I saved you.
We're weakened because we're split from each other.
And that's such a theme of the show over and over and over again, is whenever you create a home, it will not last long. It will always change and you will always suffer more loss, and what will you do?
What's great about the second half is there's really personal moments between our characters.
The back eight feels like a whole new season. We're moving into a much more psychological horror.
Fans can look forward to seeing the emotional ends to these stories. We'll see these characters change a great deal from where they started.
As they begin to cross paths, whether they actually connect or don't connect, we realize that the world is spreading and the world's getting larger.
There's a lot of relationships that are cemented, there's some that are broken, and how are they going to be facing what looks to be an even more brutal world?
We find Rick, and he's not only physically battered, he's also psychologically bereft.
Slow down.
You see a man that's very, very scared, and it comes out as a much more aggressive, protective father figure.
I'm interested to see how Carl responds to his father after losing one of the most important parts in the family unit.
Being right next to Herschel when that happened, it really is a question of what is the damage due to Michonne? How is she gonna process that loss? It is very tricky for her to find peace considering all the destruction that happened.
Maggie definitely is channeling that grief straight into anger.
Daryl has been changing a lot. I mean, I don't think any of these characters are the same people as when we first started. All of us have become so hard now.
Come on, help!
We don't know what happens to Glenn. He's on that bus. They shot bullets at the bus. This is true survival. This is truly how do you persevere on your own? Are you able to, or do you need the person next to you? There's a lot of questions.
We're about to go into uncharted waters.
It's gonna be a really intense group of episodes coming back.
I think it's gonna be exciting to see what they do after they've lost everything.
It's moving the show into a much deeper and darker and more grown-up territory. We're jumping off the cliff in this back eight.
The Walking Dead returns with new episodes Sunday, February 9th at 9, only on AMC. For more exclusive video, go to AMC.com.